Dorothy just now?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. You all set?
Can you zoom into this?
Sure, we'll get in as close as we can. How's that?
Zoom.
Yeah.
This is what we call zooming, everybody. You at home watchers?
Yeah.
Anyone who are not watching, this is what we call zooming.
Zoom. Yeah. Time. Then the moon, like a silver bow, shall be held our wedding ceremonies. Go, master of revels. Stir up the Athenian youth to merriment. Await the pert and nimble spirit of mirth, and all Athens shall celebrate. Hippolyta, I would use my sword, but I'll wed thee in another key, with pomp, with triumph, and with revelry.
Have you beat Theseus, our renowned duke?
Thanks, good Theseus. What's the news?
Full of vexation, come I with complaints against my daughter Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. My noble lord, this man has my consent to marry Hermia. Stand forth, Lysander. And my gracious duke, this man hath bewitched my child. Lysander, thou hast by moonlight at your window, son, thou hast given her bracelets, rings, nosegays, and trinkets. With cunning thou hast turned my daughter's obedience to stubbornness. And thou, my gracious duke, she will not consent to marry Demetrius. I beg the ancient privilege of Athens, as she is mine, I may dispose of her, which shall be either to this gentleman or to her death according to our law.
What say you, Hermia?
Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is Lysander.
He is, but lacking your father's consent. The other must be held worthier.
I would my father look but with my eyes.
Your eyes must look with his judgment.
I do entreat your grace to pardon me. I made bold, but I know the worst that could happen to me if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Is it to die with death, or to abjure from the society of men? So, for Hermia, question your desires. Can you endure the life of a nun?
Yes, I will, my lord, before I ever marry a man I do not love.
Be not hasty. Take time to think. And by the new moon, is it fair to die for disobedience to your father's will? Or else, to wed Demetrius, or to join a nunnery?
Relent, sweet Hermia, and Lysander, yield to my certain rights. You have a father.
true knave sprite called Robin Hood. Are you not he that misleads night wanderers, laughing at their confusion? Those that call a sweet pup. You should do the work and they'll have good luck. Are you not he?
That's right. I am that merry wanderer of the night. I guessed Oberon to make him smile. And here comes Oberon. And here my mistress.
Ill met by moonlight, proud Titania.
What? Jealous Oberon? Fairies, let us go. I abhor more in his company.
Tarry, rash Titania. Am I not thy lord?
Then I must be thy lady. Never since the middle summer spring met we, but with thy brawls thou hast disturbed our sport. Therefore the spring, the summer, the autumn, angry winter, change their appearance, and the amazed world knows not which season is which. This is what comes of our dissension. We are the cause.
You lament, then, it is your fault. Why should Titania cross your over? I do but beg a little changeling boy to be my henchman.
Set your heart at rest. The fairling boy is not the child of me. His mother was my friend, and for her sake do I rear poor boy. I will not part with him.
How long within this wood do you intend to stay?
Perhaps till after feast and spring day. If you will patiently dance all round and see our moonlight revels, go with us. If not, shun me, and I will spare thee harm.
Give me that boy, and I will go with thee.
Not for thy fairy kingdom. Fairies, away, we shall argue more if I long or stay.
Well, go thy way. Thou shalt be sorry for this. My gentle pup, come hither. Fetch me that flower, the herb I showed thee once. The juice of it, a sleeping eyelid slave, will make a man or woman fall madly in love with the next live creature that sees. Fetch me this herb, and be thou here again quickly.
I'll put a girl about the earth in 40 minutes.
Having once this juice, a watch Titania, she is asleep, and drop the liquor of it in high. Then, the next thing, and she, waking, looks upon, be it lying there, meddling monkey, she shall pursue it with the soul of love. But before I take this charm of her sight, I'll render up her page to me. But who comes here? I am invisible, and I'll overhear their conference.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not. Where is Lysander and fair Hermia? You told me there is a storm within this wood. Stop following me.
You draw me like a magnet. Leave your power to draw, and I shall have no power to follow you.
Do I entice you? Or are there not in the plainest truth do I tell you that I do not nor cannot love you?
And even for that do I love you the more. Demetrius spurned me, neglected me. Only let me follow you.
Tip not too much the hatred of my spirit, for I am sick when I look on you.
And I am sick when I look not on you.
You must return to the city. Younger like you should not be out in the woods alone.
It is not night when I deceive your fate, nor doth this wood like world of company.
You are all the world.
Then how can you say I'm alone when all the world is here?
I'll run from thee, and hide, and lead thee to the mercy of the wild beast.
The wildest hath not such a heart as you.
I will not stay. Let me go, and don't follow me.
Aye, in the town, in the field, I'll follow thee.
Fare thee well, young lady. Before you leave this grove, thou shalt run from me, and we shall seek thy death. Hast thou the flower there?
Aye, there it is.
Give it to me. I know a bench where the wild flowers grow. There sleeps Titania, and with its juice I'll streak her eyes. Take some of it, and seek through this grove. A sweet Athenian lady is madly in love with a disdainful youth. Anoint his eyes, but do it when the next thing he sees may be the lady. You will know the man by the Athenian garments he hath on.
Fear not, my lord, your servant shall do so.
Bye.
fell down further than I imagined it would. But had the last kiss in his eyes with the love kiss that I told thee to do?
I did while he was sleeping, and the Athenian woman by his side, that when he waked, by force she must be eyed.
Stand close, this is the same Athenian.
This is the woman, but this is not the man.
Oh, why rebuke me and not love thee so?
If thou hast slain my sister in his sleep, plunge in the knife and kill me too. It cannot be that thou hast murdered him. Where is my life?
No, I am not guilty of Lysander's blood, nor is he dead that I know of.
I pray you tell me where he is.
And if I would, what should I get for?
A privilege never to see me more, whether he be dead or no.
There is no following her in this fierce vein. Here, therefore, for a while, I will remain. So sorrows, heaven is thought from here, girl. Oh, I am sleepy.
Can we mend it?
Go swifter than the wind and find Helen at my back. She is thick with sighs of love. By some illusion bring her here. I'll charm his eyes till she doth appear.
I go, I go. Look how I go. Swifter than an arrow from a bow.
Flower of this purple dye, think in the apple of his eye. When thou wakest, if she be by, thou shalt love her eye to eye.
Helena is here at hand. And the youth, pleading for her love, shall he watch for what fool of these mortals be?
Stand aside, the noise they make will cause Demetrius to wake.
Then we'll both of them lower.
Why do you think I will mockery? Look when I bow, I weep.
You're making fun of me. You love only Hermia.
No, Demetrius loves her, and he loves not you.
My love, my life, my soul, fell home.
Stop it!
love, what thou desirest to eat.
Truly a peck of good dryad. Methinks I have a great desire to bottle of hay.
I have a venturous fairy that shall seek the squirrel's hoard and fetch thee new nuts.
I had rather have a handful or two of dried peas. But I pray you, let none of your people fear me. I have a feeling of sleep come upon me.
Sleep thou, and I will wind thee in my arms. Fairies, be gone. Oh, how I love thee, how I dote on thee.
Welcome, good Puck. Seest thou the sweet sight? For dotage now I do begin to pity. For now I have the boy, I will undo the hateful imperfection of her eye.
Now, my Titania, awake you, my sweet queen.
My Oberon, what visions I have seen. Me, thought I was in love with a jackass.
There lies your life.
How came these things to pass? Oh, how mine eyes do loathe his visage now.
Silence a while. Puck, take off his head. Titania, music box, and rock the ground whereup upon these papers. We will tomorrow midnight dance in this secret house, and there shall the pair of faithful lovers be blessed with peace.
Fairy King, attend and mark.
I do hear the morning lark.
Then, my queen, trip we up the nightshade, swifter than the wandering moon.
Come, my lord, and tell me how it came about that I, sleeping here, was found with these mortals on the ground. There they are, my lord. This is my daughter here asleep, and there's Lysander. Enough, my lord. You have seen enough. I beg the law upon his head. They would have stolen away, and Demetrius there, if I to have defeated you and me.
But, my lord, I love Helena, and she loves me.
My love for Hermia melted as the snow.
Fair lovers, we are fortunately met. Of this discourse, we'll more hear enough. Aegeus, at the tip of by and by, these lovers shall be eternally knit. We will hold a feast. Come along, everyone.
More strange than true. I never believe these fairy stories. It's only their imagination.
Ah, here come the lovers, full of mirth and joy. Gentle friends, come sit down.
What masks, what dances shall we have?
Where is our usual manager of mirth?
Is there no play?
Here, my Theseus, here's a list. Make choice which your haunts will see first.
Pyramus and his love, Thisbe.
If we shadows have offended, think that even slumber healed all these visions that appear. Now that I am an honest Puck, good night and to you all.
Kentucky. Still in the process of putting stuff away, of course. The paint is just drying.
She just put grease all over all the clean pots and pans in here in her hurry to put
it away. How's this job?
Why didn't you wash it?
What'd you do? You pulled that off with
this
the...
wasn't clean.
Oh, so be reckless.
Don't wear it out, please.
You ain't got 9 things to wash.
Come on, Justin, Gaz, let's say hello here.
Hello.
Hello. They won't not stop people.
Don't blame anybody else.
Oh, tell me, how do you know
I'm in the kitchen?
And
then
I come in and I dump it. I'm here. I don't be quiet.
Well, you ought to be quiet. That's all I'm saying.
Hey. June 16th, 1990. We just got here from Buffalo. This is Pat and Kate's new neighborhood. There's the church that they're living next door to. And that's their white house through the tree there. So you can see they've got a special kind of protection here. I thought I'd take these pictures because you never know what tomorrow may bring, right? It's nice quiet here. This is a little town named Stuyvesant. It's been here a couple years. We looked at a couple of headstones in the cemetery that go back to 17 something. I guess you hear the train. I don't know if I'm going to see it from here. There's the Hudson River. Maybe I caught sight of the top of the train passing through, one of the expresses that bring people from New York City probably over to Boston. We're right on the borderline of Connecticut, Massachusetts, all those goody little states. Had a nice trip out. Hardly got lost for over 10 hours. Peaceful, isn't it? There's our girlfriend Katrina out in her backyard. It's probably goes back quite a ways. And it goes across the back there, past the church, and just about in line with that line of trees. And then back from there to the woods that you see back in the distance. But this is a little bit of a view of the house, one of the angles. It's a nice house. Go down the front drive here a little further and get the more of a front angle. It's a frontal angle of the house. It's old and it's spacious. Maybe we'll get some inside shots. Give you an idea what it looks like. is a wash. A lot of winter to keep out. A little bit of the side back type of thing. A little porch in the back there off the kitchen and the pantry area. And there's part of the back property. Goes into those woods for about 50, 75 yards. And like I say, it crosses over back behind the house and behind the church. And it's a fair piece of ground. Now we're looking back across the Hudson. From the front stoop of the house. It's a beautiful view. And of course, this time of the evening, it's a wee bit overcast. See how low the sun is in the sky. It's getting that time. This is my friend Gabi. Say hello. Say hello, Gina. You gonna say hello to Gina? Huh? What are you looking at? The plane? Do you know your cousin Gina? Mm-hmm. Say hiya, Gina. Wave to her. She's in the camera. You feel bashful today?
Mm-hmm. This is a view of the area from our bedroom window. It's around 8 o'clock in the morning. is that? Every once in a while, the stillness is punctuated by a train whistle. Goes down the track, side of the river.
I think this is self-explanatory.
Watch when you back up.
This girl takes her clothes off at every opportunity.
I got that for me.
A bag sack. Where are you going now? What you're going to see is coming in the front door, Pat and Kate's house in Stuyvesant, New York. And this is the front porch. It's enclosed. Most of the windows have been cleaned, and some of the paint has been scraped, but there's work to do, as everyone knows, as moved into an older home. I brought her a little solar dryer to help her with her blouses and small stuff. View there I've been trying to show you. You can see it's quite a big porch. Ceiling's in perfect shape. The floor needs some more painting and scraping. And right now it's cool, even though the sun out there got the temperature up to, I would say, around 80. Now this is the doorway proper, a small vestibule going in. Anything you'd like. But the place is furnished with the just about anything and everything that they could get their hands on at this point. Stuff that was in Virginia, Washington, New York. The hall, entrance hallway, into it, you probably can't consider it. Fireplace. Just remember that we all came in here last night unloaded. And of course, you know, we're not waiting for anybody to clean up or straighten up.
Bathing beauty out here, you might want to get a shower on your towel.
This guy's trying to get the bathing beauty in.
Right. We got her. She's out here sunning herself.
stairways side by side. The one on the left is up to the sleeping quarters, and one on the right is up to the maid's quarters.
Yeah, we've got dinner plates, 20, I think, that we bought there. And all the wine glasses and
whose room this is. You know who that is. This is the relaxing weekend. There we go. Now we're going to go up the stairs.
Yeah.
maid's room. Bathroom. Gabby's room. She camps out when she's here. Good size room. Good view. Laboratory. Through all the stuff. My command took what I needed and walked out. This is the window that I took the view of the Hudson River. There's the bathroom door. That same bathroom. Just looked. Just left. Need a lot of work, a lot of upkeep, but it's really not a lot.
That's not my cup of tea.
I'm gonna make a nice coffee in the afternoon now.
Well, I gotta get a early Sunday morning kitchen scene. Night's sleep?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You coming down for a little breakfast? Huh?
Mommy gets there.
Okay, you come down too. Come on.
I'm gonna go see Grandma, okay?
You're gonna come and see Grandma?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. There's the farmers out there, the little garden.
Matthew was.
Can you do
pat?
You're size 8. You're 7 and a half.
Lily's here. Yay.
Hold on.
that would make such a great photo.
I'm going to get it in a second, Kate.
You ready? All right, here I come.
Whee!
I got it.
You're going to get me?
Okay, I'm ready.
Here. Oh, Clem.
The cake.
Where is he?
You look great without your braces.
She has cake in her hair.
Hold off!
No! Don't take a picture of me!
Perfume does she have on?
I think it's called Night hey, Before Lovers and a Goat.
No, I was telling you about Freddy's.
You're say goodbye, Gabby.
I have some.
We have some.
Oh, I can play. Here, sit right down here for a second while I get some.
Say goodbye.
I think I still have a half from the last.
Wave to the camera.
Look and see what
I've got. Bye, sweetie.
Watch out, you got another peanut roaming around.
Thank you.
You waving bye-bye? With your cousin while she was here? Careful.
In Chapel Hill, North Carolina. This is Gray Bluff Road, and we're approaching the new home of the family of Francis and Louise D'Addario. That is their number. And this is their driveway. A lot different from their home in Kentucky, as you can see. Where the trees let off, trees begin. There I am, half unpacked. Ran into the camera and I thought I'd get a few pictures before the light gave out. Property line is just about where the cans are there on that side. Goes back to a creek. They have an easement on the property. I guess to get them across the creek if they ever have to. Beginning of a new rock garden. There's the back patio. Isn't that a peaceful family scene?
Beer, it was fizzing before.
Everybody's tired.
It's forced it.
It
wasn't
a
passion.
Your beer's getting warm over here. Take a break.
Okay, I'll be there in a half second.
I was straight.
clean up the sink.
All right. This is the inside of the house. Coming into the kitchen dining room area. This is going to be... Fire Fran's office here. You can see they're not quite unpacked and settled in. What with school starting and all of that stuff. Spacious room. Here. This is Jade's room. Just a few odds and ends. To keep her occupied. As you can see, these rooms are large and well lit. Private fireplace. Old closet. There's a closet outside of the room. Another room here. I'm not sure who's. You've seen it's used, and it's not quite settled yet.
Okay, this goes off after this show.
Francisco.
All right.
That's cheating, Dad.
Dad, you did it all my way. Look.
You have it all for all my way.
Guess who? I don't want to tell you whose room this is.
There's a big spider out here.
Yeah, there's a lot of spiders. They're the ones that catch all the...
Oh, like this one that you can actually see from the window.
The flying things. Worthy of the news.
Emmy Award winner. Fell at the stunt man, tired of crashed right.
I took a picture of it. This is the room of the mistress and master of the house.